If you're free, give him another hand clap of praise. Ah, oh, listen now as we sing. Once like a bird in prison I dwell, no freedom from my sorrow I fell, but Jesus came, he listened to me, and glory to God, he said.
Your grace, your mercy. God, just allowing us to be in the house of God to be able to worship you in spirit and in truth. Thank you, dear Father, for every home and every family, God, that's represented here today. Father, I pray, God, that you touch God's people. And Father, there be one under the sound of my voice, God, that don't know you in their free part of sin. Father, today would be the day, God, that you grip their soul, they'd come to this altar, give their heart and life to you. Lord, we only have a few more grains of sand left in the hourglass of time this side of heaven. And Father, I pray, God, that you touch lives, God, today. And for the saints of God that may be in this building, God, they've been born again for many years, but God, they're struggling. God, they're just struggling. God, I pray that you lift the burden and the struggle that they go through. Give them the peace that passes all understanding. God, let them know that you're walking right with them today. Father, I pray for the preaching hour and the songs of Zion as it stirs our soul, God, this side of heaven. That, God, that we'd be encouraged today. God, that we leave this place much different than the way we came and be equipped for the next week. God, fill us, God, today and thrill our soul. And we'll love you and thank you for all that you do. In Christ's name we pray, and the people of God say, amen. Give the Lord praise as you're being seated over the house today. It is a joy to be in the house of God today. Oh, listen now. Oh, breaks him down to his knees. You see today, God, I've been broken more than a time or two. Yes, Lord, but he picked me up and he showed me what it means to be a man. I wish I had a witness in the building today.
Confidence in our government and all that, but I'm telling you what, there's only one we can put our hope in, and his name is Jesus. He went to when you went to bed last night, he was God. When you got up this morning, he's still God, and tomorrow he'll still be God. Whatever happens, whatever goes on, I'm glad to know there's a rock that I can put my confidence in and my hope in, and our rock is Jesus this morning. Amen. What a joy to be in the house of the Lord. Thank you for coming today. We're looking forward to the Lord doing something special. If you need something from God, I believe you showed up at the right place. And I'm believing God to do great things for you and for me. How many of you know your pastor needs the help of the Lord and the touch of the Lord as well? We all, ain't none of us walking on water. We all need God's help and God's touch, amen? I want to do this. I want you to stand up right there where you're at. If you've never been here before, thank you. Thank you. There's hundreds of churches in this county, and you decided to come here. Thank you so much for coming out to be with us today. It is a joy to have you. We'd love to talk to you following the service. And I want you to just play a little something, just something. We ain't gonna do handshaking and all that just yet, but I just want just a little bit of, you can walk around a little bit and wave at people. Thank you for coming out to church, and we certainly do appreciate you being here. Thank you. My man Brody was up here cutting a rug in the Holy Ghost. Amen. Thank the Lord for that. You can be seated. Man, it's good. I was talking to a couple of people, and they said, "Preacher, we've got a lot of new folk that I don't know. And I hate that they don't know you, and you don't know them, but I'm thankful when we have that problem." And there's way too many churches that sit around stagnant and just die on the vine. I don't want us to be that way. I want us to continue to try to reach people and to see what the Lord does. These two precious ladies they've probably been singing this song for probably ever since it came out, I reckon. I don't know how long this song's been out. Like 20, probably 20 years. 20 years, right, 20 years. I better hush up. Listen while they say.
Well, if I didn't help you, just hang on. There'll be more help on the way. Amen. I've just come too far to turn and go back now. Serve the Lord too long. He's been too good to me. Can we stand all over the house today and just worship? be seated if you can today. Anybody know about the goodness of God? It is the goodness of God, the grace of God allowed you to get up today and be at the house of God. I have so much to thank him for. He sure has been better to me than I deserve. If we think about it just a minute, boy, he sure has been good. Listen.
Thank you. fail. We all, just like the preacher said, none of us walking on water, you know. But anytime I fail, God's always still been faithful to show that He still loves us. He still loves me. He forgives. He's quick to forgive. And I just thank God for always being faithful and always being there for me. Anytime I pray, He's answered my prayers. So I just love the Lord.
Anybody else want to testify to the goodness of God?
Brother Chris, I'm going to stand up, thank God for saving my word and soul. I can't really say it in spite of myself and believing you. We went to Cabin's wedding yesterday. All the family come together. You know, all the children, grandchildren, great-grandchildren. We just had a wonderful time together. Some of those folks lost, some of them need the Savior. And I'm so glad that God is using His goodness. Yeah. He's drawing them unto Him, and He speaks to them every day of their life. And I believe all my heart that God is saving them soul. And I just want to thank God for the good fellowship, the good family time that we did have yesterday. Even in spite of sin, God still blesses His children. Yeah. He still loves His children. And I want to thank God for the good spirit here this morning. I ask nothing anybody's done. It's for the goodness and the mercy of our Lord and Savior. You feel that sweet spirit, that sweet oasis to the soul. And I just want to say I love you. I love God, and I'm so thankful to be a member of the family of God.
Somebody else just want to brag on Jesus. Go ahead, Jay. He's faithful to me, and I love Him with all my heart, and
almost 2 years. I think I've been here almost 2 years. January will be 2 years. And I remember that morning when I was like, where do you want me to go? I don't know what to do. I don't know where to go. And all I could see was Robert and Liam. I could just see them. And I was like, okay, I'll go to Maranatha. And I'm so glad I did. So thankful for each and every one of y'all. I love y'all. I love my pastor and his wife. And now the Lord is hopefully leading my sister here. You know, God knows what he's doing. He puts pieces together in his time. I don't know what my future holds, but God does. And I'm so thankful I have new family and new friends. Because God showed me that in the book of Isaiah about 2 years ago, and I didn't understand. A new life, a fresh start, new friends, new family. I didn't know. I thought maybe Eric was going to get saved and God was going to turn all that around. You know, I was like, somehow. But I don't know, you know. Whatever the Lord wants for my life, I'm just thankful that I have a friends and family church that's going to go through me. I love you.
Anyone else?
Line in the song that says, I have lived in the goodness of God. And every time I hear that, I hear it on the radio or I hear Patricia sing it, I think about how I have lived in the goodness of God and how Chris and I have lived in the goodness of God. If you look over our marriage, I mean, it's almost like there was a fence around us and there was no way that the Lord wasn't going to provide for us and take care of us and lead us. And it's been so, so good to us. There's so many things that could have happened that God hasn't allowed to happen. And I'm just so thankful for his goodness and his faithfulness. And even if he never did another thing, he's been so good to us. I'm so thankful for that faithfulness.
I'd like to talk to you about the church. So good, with every breath.
Y'all can take a stay right here. You can be seated. The Bible said this, when my father and my mother forsake me, then the Lord will take me up. Teach me thy way, O Lord. Lead me in. Y'all come back here. I don't know where y'all going. Y'all stand right there. Amen. Teach me thy way, O Lord. Lead me in a plain path because of mine enemies. Deliver me not over unto the will of mine enemies, for false witnesses are risen up against me, and such as breathe out cruelty. I had fainted unless I had believed to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Wait on the Lord, be of good courage, and he shall strengthen thy heart. Wait, I say, on the Lord. Give me that verse, or the chorus. Just want one of you. Through the valley of the shadow of death, thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest me a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely, 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 surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Somebody ought to send me that to get this.
For there shall no man see me and live. And the Lord said, behold,
there is a place by me, and thou shalt stand upon the rock, and it shall come to pass while my glory passes by. I will put thee, hallelujah, I'll put thee in the cleft of the rock and cover thee with my hand while I pass by. Somebody ought to sing of the goodness of God. Mercy for thousands, forgiving iniquity and transgression and sin, and that will by no means clear the guilty, visiting the iniquity of the fathers unto their children, and upon the children's children unto the third and fourth generation. I'm thankful that even though we may be born in sin, we may be born in a heritage of sin, I'm thankful that God can step, hallelujah, God can step in and turn all that around. God can step in and change nations and generations. God, it may have run in your family, but I'm glad, hallelujah, it can stop in your family as well. I'm glad to tell you, there's a God that's running after you. See, the goodness of God, it surrounds me. He goes before me. The Bible said, he's behind me. Everywhere I look, I'm bumping into it. I'm bumping in to the mercy and goodness of God. I say, bless his name. Thank you, God, for your goodness on us.
Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. With my mind laid down, I surrender now. I give you everything.
Lay down on the altar and say, God,
your goodness is running after.
are praying, how many more of us, y'all just keep playing something real soft right there, how many of us more will come and say, God, I come to lay down my life. Lord, I come to lay down before you and say, God, I can't do this by myself. I need your help. I like what Brother Ronnie said. The Bible said in Romans chapter number 2, the goodness of the Lord leadeth thee to repentance. Some of you right now don't feel like that you're worthy of the goodness of God. You don't feel like that you're worthy of the grace of God. You don't feel like you're worthy of the love of God. He loves you just like you are. And the Bible said, but God commendeth his love toward us in that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. Right there where you're at, in all of your mess, Jesus loves you. He's running after you. I wonder how many of us would come and say, God, I need your help. Come on, come on.
All my life.
All my life you have been faithful. And all my life you have been so
testimony, how that God has been good to you, and now your boys and your grandchildren and your great-grandchildren. God longs to give us good things. God longs to show his mercy to generations, to thousands. So I want you to do this. Ronnie, you get your family together. Rick, I want you to go back there with Mom and Neil. I want you to pray. I want you to find those that are part of your family, and I want you to pray together. Y'all sing something else.
So good with every breath that
really short version. I'm not sure if I can do it, but many of you have heard my testimony before. Some of you haven't. I was 9 years old. My mom left me. My grandmother raised me. She adopted me, but we lived with her for a little while. My mom took me away from family. She put me in a position where I was beaten, where the person that she was with didn't love me. She didn't love me. She would leave me by myself. Again, I was 9 years old. Thank God for the goodness of God, because I don't know where I'd be if it hadn't have been for my grandparents. I slipped a note into my cousin's book bag. We were in elementary school, and I slipped a note in her book bag, and I said, make sure you give this to Mom. I said, please give it to Mom. That night, I was sitting in a trailer up in Bessemer City. Knock on the door. I didn't have a clue where I was, who I was with. But a knock on the door, and it was two police officers and my grandma. They come and took me out of that situation. And thank God for the goodness of God, because I don't know where I'd be if it wasn't for Him.
I don't know where any of us would be but for the goodness of God. Probably would be in jail, definitely needed to be in hell. But God saw otherwise. What a blessing. Getting ready to have a prayer here at the end. I was back there weeping and crying, and I forgot my handkerchief. And I kept feeling something in my pocket. I said, let me reach down in there. Miss Carolyn, this might not mean to anything to you, but yeah, it does. When Slug passed away, they had some ties and some tie pins and some handkerchiefs. This is one of Slug's handkerchiefs. Y'all, they were singing about heaven, and I reached down and pulled that out. And I said, man, what a time he's had. Every loved one you've had to say goodbye to here that knows Jesus, oh, what a glorious day it is for them. However, there may be some in this room right now that if it was your time, you know the Bible does say it is appointed unto man once to die, and after this the judgment. The Bible tells us that. If it's your time, how's it going to be with you, friend? Are you ready to meet God like you are? With heads bowed and eyes closed. You're here this morning and you know without a doubt you're saved. Your relationship is not where it needs to be with God. I wonder if we'd be honest enough just to throw up our hand. God, we see those. We see those hands going up. Here's my hand. God, you know where I'm at. I need your help. God, speak to our hearts. In all these hands, Lord, you know their situation. You know their names. You know where they're at. Help them. You're here this morning to say this, preacher, I'm not 100% sure. If I were to die, I don't know where I'm going to spend eternity. I'm not ready to meet God. Would you be honest enough just to slip your hand up, put it right back down? Thank you. Here's my hand. There's one. Is there somebody else? Preacher, would you pray for me? I won't come to you, call you out. I won't embarrass you, but I will pray for you. Preacher, here's my hand. Please pray for me. I do not know. Thank you. Thank you. Are there more? God's speaking and God's drawing. Here's my hand. He's running after you, friend. He's got you surrounded. Preacher, I do not know for sure. Would you pray for me? Is there somebody else before we pray? Here's my hand. I want you, every one of you, all over the room, I want you to stand with me. I want everyone to stand. We're almost done. Bow your head once you're standing, there. I'm getting ready to pray a prayer, and I can guarantee you this. If the words I pray are just my words, this prayer will do nothing and will mean nothing. However, if you'll pray a prayer like this and mean it in your heart, Jesus can save you right where you're at. Jesus can come into your heart, change your life and your eternity. Let's pray. Dear Jesus, please forgive me. I've messed up. I've done wrong. I've got problems. Lord, you know about them. I need your help. I need you to come into my life. I don't want to go to hell. I know you love me. I know that you died on Calvary for me. And I'm asking you to forgive me. Come into my heart. Change me. Save me right now. With heads bowed and eyes closed. I wonder, here comes one already. Is there somebody else? Preacher, here's my hand. I prayed that prayer and I asked Jesus to be my Savior this morning. Here's my hand. Is there anybody else we can thank the Lord for? Oh God, speak to hearts. God bless you, sister. While God's drawing, don't tell him no again. You may not have another opportunity. Behold, today is the day of salvation. Now is the accepted time. 2 Corinthians 6 and verse number 2. God is drawing. God is calling. Don't tell him no again. They're going to sing that last verse, just the last section, one more time. Here we go. While God's dealing with this one, is there somebody else who raised your hand? Maybe you didn't. God's dealing with your heart. Come on. Come on. Get it right today. just got born again.
Oh.
She was in a car seat. What the kind you carry in because they're infant. And Leah brought her and Lauren here. Larry was being stubborn, wasn't in church yet, wasn't thankful. And I was so excited. This is 2004. So excited to see some young children. And Kelly said I probably scared Leah. She's messing with both of her kids. And if you remember Lauren at that age, she was wild. And I was trying to help them back out to the car, and I carried her in the little car seat. Why are you just up there singing? I was thinking your whole life. No, nothing but the goodness of God. You know, there's a lot of testimonies about getting saved out of drugs and alcohol and illicit lifestyle, and thank God he does. But even better than that is for God to keep you from it. God is good to us, church.
Hallelujah.
Well, I feel like I'm about to act like Peter. Let's build three tabernacles. Just stay here all day. Amen. thank you so much. Ladies, y'all got us in the glory.
Amen.
Amen.
God bless
you. Amen. They don't get to sing as often as they used to, but man, when they do, they bring it every time, y'all. Amen. We thank the Lord for it, and we love them, and we love y'all. I want to do something. Miss Midge, you're probably going to have to help me do this. I didn't think it through. We've got to get some buckets. We've got an opportunity. Miss Fraley's, I don't even know, great, it's Erica's children. Great-grandchildren, great-great-grandchildren, whatever they are to you. They're in a tough situation right now, and Daniel and Brittany have taken custody of them, and they need to do some legal work. And they've got to raise the money by October the 12th, I think the day is. They need to raise $1,000. To take care of this. We've got some in our benevolence that we can give toward it. We've had somebody to tell me they'll make up the difference of what we couldn't do. But between now and the 12th, in those buckets, I want us to raise $1,000 to take care of the legal fund and get those kids to where they don't have to go to foster home or back into a bad situation. And if you didn't come prepared to give today, we're going to do this through the October the 10th, I think it's the last Sunday before that. And so I want you to give what you give in those chicken buckets. We'll go toward that need. We'll have somebody take our regular offering. Haven, can you take care of getting our regular offering there? There's some plates somewhere around there. And we'll receive our regular offering on the way out. But if you talk about the goodness of God, sometimes God uses people to show his goodness. And this would be easy for us to do. We got 10 people, no doubt, right now, they could give $100 between now and then, and you probably wouldn't hardly even miss it. And so we want to bless these children and get them out of the mess they're in and get them to a good, loving home and to be a blessing to them. All right? So you give toward that need, and you see the plates there. Those will go to our regular tithe and offering. So you take care of that. All right? Brother Ronnie, I want you to pray over those children. I want you to pray for this offering.
Thank you, God, for every soul that's helped you this morning. God, you truly are so, so good. And God, we want to lift up especially those little children for a Christmas. Dear God, you will hang upon them to protect them from the evils of this world. To undertake on their behalf, help them be put in the proper place, God, where there is love and the mercy and grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Oh God, that you'd save those children at an early age. They wouldn't have to suffer long from some sin and Satan. They'd be your faithful servants. And God, we pray that you bless the gift, those who are able to give, those who are not able. And we pray that God would bless us all. As always, you will glory and honor and praise to help of our kingdom to save our souls. Dear God, we love you this morning. Pray, God, you bless us with your faith and hope. The love of one another, the love of Jesus. God, the love of the lost and dying world into the kingdom. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
One more thing before you leave. We need about 6 or 7 more people to sign up for Trunk or Treat this Wednesday before Halloween. So 6 or 7 more people. Thank you.